No, tell me. Okay, so we're going to start working on the shoulders, on the point of the scapula. So I go very slowly here, all the way to the front of the scapula. And I make the blade come in behind the scapula, between the scapula and the spine. Now let it vibrate there. So I'm trying to get a good looseness between the shoulder and the neck. So this work can be done literally. Let's turn around here. Everywhere on the horse's body. So if I feel a little spasm, like here, vibrate a little bit, I'm going to keep it there until I get a relaxation. Now it feels completely soft, right? And there's nothing going against this flexion here. Okay, so now if I want to work on the other side of this flexion, right? Here. I'm trying to slide the blade very progressively. And we're going to try to bend a little more. Try to find any place where it can be a restriction. The horse is completely comfortable in this flexion because he stays there. Oh, just help me out. Thank you. He's happy to do that. And that shoulder is really free here. Okay. So you catch here. I'm going to wait. His face, I think he's liking that. And what I found is that when I do that work one day, I usually don't have to do the same work the next day. That whatever spasm was here today is usually gone tomorrow. That doesn't mean there isn't any more, but not that one. So you can work on the shoulders like this. you can work on the back. I'm going to go back to the other side. So here, okay, so can't go behind him for a second. Lengthening the iliac spine here, and I'm not encountering anything. Right? There's no spasm anywhere. And I'm pushing the common muscle down. So there's nothing there. And I'm also bending right. So it's lengthening that side. So then you can do the same on the other side. So now I'm going to relax his hind leg. So I'm going very gently here. So if you look, there's a lot of vibration in that muscle there. I don't know if you can see it from there, but the muscle is vibrating like crazy. I go very gently and I wait till it goes. Now. So that's very tight muscle. Good push. I put my weight on the hog. The foot is extending a little bit. I'm pushing it gently with my knee. Let go. Good way. More for my benefit than his. So there's a lot of tension in those muscles. Every horse is different, but those horses, I'm going very gently with the point of the blade. And I'm focusing, good boy, that's better. That's better. Okay, so what I'm focusing on is not a muscle knot or soreness, is simply the spasm. The spasm that is there in a certain position is going to increase as soon as you add movement and speed and effort, right? So it's just like the software of the horse. You know, the horse is used to, in this particular position, at this particular phase of the trot or the canter or any gait, when the leg goes back, he is programmed to tighten and jerk his leg back forward again, right? And he's just too tight.
So we're going to do that again.
Oh, very gently, I'm putting the lid back. Go here. There's still plenty of spasm left, but it's getting to be less.
Okay.
So that's the general idea. Okay? You can do that. So see that we went picking up his left hind foot and pull it forward. So there's less spasm when he is engaged than when he is pushing back. So now that I've stretched him in the other direction, I'm going to see if it's any better with the leg pulled back. So we have to remember that the sequence in which the muscle reacts is always the same. The muscle will resist, ignore, relax, and change. When he changes, that's when he increases the motion range. And then after that, he can retain the new muscle memory. So when the horse is tightening and the muscle is vibrating and he's pulling against me, that's the resist phase. When he stops that, that starts to be the ignore phase. Then I do a little bit more, then he let go, and he's relaxing, and then I can increase his movement. So now we're gonna work on his front legs. So let's go to the left front. The cedar is gonna pick up the left front, and there. Okay, I'll be here on the side, okay? Okay, so. What we're looking for is an extension towards the front. Which is quite happy to do. Good boy. Good boy. And all the muscles are lengthening. So that's called eccentric contraction. As opposed to concentric contraction. Concentric is when the muscle is moving. So I can see a vibration here. Okay. So what's interesting is that there's always related contractions, right? So I'm stretched and I'm working on the flexor muscle of his forearm, but something in his chest start to vibrate and tighten. So if I put my hand on there, and I vibrate my hand a little bit, hopefully I'm going to get rid of that one. So we're going to do this one again, but we're going to do it more to the side. Okay? So you might see it better from the front, maybe. So you can see that when that leg is up, the pectoral here is all tied in and it's pulling the sternum to the left. And at the same time the withers go to the right. That's the position of the horse bent left. Okay, we're good. Good boy. Okay, so now we're going to work the right front just a little bit. So one of the legs is always going to be tighter than the other one. You know, usually the one that the horse wants to stand over. So, you know, when he grazes, you will notice that one leg is going to be more under the body than the other one. That one's not even as tall as that one. Okay, so go directly to the right. As we did this, he adjusted his elbow, had a big loud crack in there. So those are a few examples of all the releases that you can work on, right? If the horse has been well suppled, put inside, he will be comfortable to stand square. Not too many problems or supplements for him. Don't forget to turn the machine off. And voila! Good boy. So it shows, you know, how relaxed the horse is after that. They feel a lot better because all of those little muscle tension end up acting on the brain tension. You know, but you could not be any more relaxed than that. Okay, that concludes that.